XFM News. On point.
Thank you for joining us. Here's a quick look at the news. I'm Lynn Komjisha. The government has confirmed that the deputy government spokesperson, Colonel Shaban Bantariza, died of COVID-19. This has been confirmed by government spokesperson Ofwono Opondo at Mulago Hospital, where the body is being kept. Opondo described the late as a hard-working person who was always committed to his job. He said talks are still going on with family members on the day for burial.
So close to me now, and we want to caution the public that COVID is real. Because of this confirmation that he has died of COVID, we shall endeavor as a government family observe all the SOPs in relation to the burial of somebody who has died of COVID. We don't know as yet when we shall actually do the burial, and that will be known perhaps later this evening.
The Minister of ICT, Judith Nawakowa, has sent her condolences to the family of the late Shaban Bantariza, who passed on at Mulago Hospital this morning. In her statement, she said Bantariza built a professional media relationship with the army and the citizens, which is still strong. Nawakowa also added that Bantariza has been actively involved in civic education, especially among his youth, in preparation for the forthcoming general elections. Other government officials have sent in their condolences to the Minister of Works, General Katumba Wamala, UPDF spokesperson Brigadier Flavia Vyekwaso, acting in ED of Uganda Communications Commission, Engineer Irene Kagwa, Serunkuma, Presidential Advisor on Special Operations, Lieutenant General Muhoozi Karugaba, Kane Rugaba, among others. The ruling party of the NRM has paid tribute to the late deputy government spokesperson, Colonel Shaban Bantariza. Bantariza had been nominated to contest for the position of vice chairman, NRM in charge of Western Region, was disqualified from the race on grounds of being a government official. The spokesperson of the NRM, Rogers Merindo, says before he fell sick, the secretariat had appointed him part of the reconciliatory committee in the areas of Busia, Butaleja and Chibuku district, but he returned the resources after feeling unwell to perform the duties.
He has always been there whenever he's needed. He's not the kind of a person you would call to say, Apande, where are you? We have a program on this TV. Can you please find time for this? He would always say, I'm coming, and he would always avail himself. We have a challenge in the party that some people feel for them to attend media shows, they need to be facilitated. Colonel Shaban Bantariza was not that kind. So he has left us a very big gap, especially at this time when we are going to run scientific campaigns. We thought he would be around to help us bridge up some of these gaps. He has gone too early, but we pray that God comforts his family, and then we also pray that he rests in peace.
Police has warned presidential aspirants to stop mobilizing their supporters to escort them for nomination next week. The Kampala Metropolitan Police PRO Patrick Onyango says any presidential aspirant that makes a precision contrary to the Electoral Commission guidelines that require only 10 people will be arrested and detained. He appeals the supporters to continue observing directives put in place to fight COVID-19.
The law authorizes police to detain such a person or a suspect for 48 hours, and those are 2 days. We appeal to the aspirants not to defy the Independent Electoral Commission guidelines.
In other news, 2 university students in Kenya have been charged with hacking into a local bank and stealing millions. The students at Jomo Kenyatta University of Agriculture and Technology, located on the outskirts of the capital, Nairobi, are accused of stealing about 24 million Kenyan shillings and attempting to move an additional 190 million Kenyan shillings. The alleged offences were committed last month. Anthony Mwangi Ngige, 23, and Anne Wambui Nyoike, 21, denied these charges. That was the news.
XFM News. On point.